it takes the right people at the top to know better and to do better. I think that's why Hemptified has been such a success, and I think it's going to be kind of a blueprint for more to come.
Julissa, it is so good to see you. The last time I got to visit with you was live in New York City on set. You played like a Mexican snack taste test with us.
But it was so fun. It was so much fun.
Tell us a little bit about the show and where it centers.
Hemptified follows a Mexican family, the Morales family, and they are centered in Mama Fina's, which is the grandfather's taco shop in Boyle Heights, which is an actual neighborhood here in Los Angeles. They're actually going through gentrification, which is happening in so many parts of America. They're in the crossfire of, do they like sell out or do they strap up their boots and kind of just like do what they've been doing? But if they do that, do they like get left behind because the town is changing? My role is Jessica Castillo, who is Anna, the lead of the show. It's Anna's girlfriend. Jessica is an activist. She moved to Boyle Heights when she was a teenager, and she fell in love with the neighborhood and the town and its people. And now she's kind of like not going with what's happening with gentrification. And she's one of the only ones that's standing up to the people that are coming and buying out and wanting to help out her neighborhood and let the culture sit there as it should.
I'm out here enjoying the day when there's a long list of people waiting for a miracle.
I know it's an all Latinx cast, but are the writers all Latinx as well?
Yeah.
Oh, I love hearing that.
I think that's why it's so beautiful, right? Because that's how you get authenticity when you are writing what you know. This season, there's actually only one person who's an African-American male, but besides that, everyone's Latinx, and that is so cool to see. I've never seen a writer's room like that. Ever. I feel that something like a Hemptified, where not only the writers are people that look like us, but also the execs. Actually, I want to say there was only one white exec. Everyone is of color, and most of them are women. It takes the right people at the top to know better and to do better. I think that's why Hemptified has been such a success, and I think it's going to be kind of a blueprint for more to come.
What is your favorite part about playing Jessica? What have you learned about yourself from this role?
It's just the fact that she's unapologetically herself. She's a queer woman, she's brown, she's black, she's Dominican, and she's walking in her power. Like, that to me is amazing.
Hey, what has Jessica taught you?
I think that love is love is love, right? I myself am not a woman in the queer community. I am an ally, absolutely, or an LGBTQ plus community. Walking into it, I was skeptical of like, how would I play her, but truly represent a woman that is a queer woman. I wanted to do right by her and tell her story correctly. I know what love is. I know what it feels to be loved. I know what it is to love and to hug and to kiss and to feel. And so I brought that to Jessica because at the end of the day, it doesn't matter who that person is. It just matters if you love them. And so I've grown so much because of her.
Thank you for looking out for my family.
To love Anna, you gotta love her family.
And I have to say congratulations because you guys are renewed for a season two.
Yes, it's coming. Season two is happening. I'm so excited about that.
Is there anything that you know about season two?
All I know is that they are bringing the heat and it's gonna be so good. Like, I think you're gonna be like, season one? No, this didn't even compare. I truly, truly do believe that. The characters are more explosive. You're getting a deeper dive into their personal lives a little bit more. And I think that's gonna be cool.
Within your Latinidad, how do you identify and what is it like living that identity in Hollywood?
You know what? I identify as a Latina, which is why sometimes I say that instead of saying Latinx. Mm-hmm. I also identify as a Hispanic. I come from Miami, and in Miami, we always said, oh, I'm Hispanic. Like, that's just how we grew up. I remember 7 years ago that I would walk into a room going in for a Latina role, and they'd be like, you don't look like what we were expecting. And then when I would walk in for a African-American role, as soon as I opened my mouth, they were like, no, that's not what we want. You have an accent. that. That doesn't make sense. And so I was kind of like in limbo.
You were living between two worlds.
Yeah, and not knowing like, well, what do I identify with? And how do I make this a career out of being true to myself? Because what I won't do is be a sellout or change who I am for the sake of a career.
Do you feel like Hollywood is becoming more inclusive?
I do. I feel that way. And I think that I can say proudly that I feel like I'm attributing to it, right? Because I'm not changing who I am. I'm also being very vocal on what Afro-Latinidad is and what that means and what's going on and how we need to do better. I think that everyone should know that there's not one country in Latin America or in the Caribbean that doesn't have Black people, regardless of where they are. I don't care if you're talking about Mexico. I don't care if you're talking about Cuba. I don't care if you're talking about Honduras. Every country of Latin background has Black people. So we have to remember, if you're proud of where you come from, then you have to be proud of everywhere of that you come from and everything that you come from, including the Black brothers and sisters that we're talking about, the Black Latinos. And so this Black Lives Matter movement is such an effect right now. And that, I would say, has attributed to a lot of people waking up and also owning who they are and being able to speak up and speak proudly about who you are.